Some very important jargon that's going to apply to all the statistics you're going to learn in this class is there are various names for this percent of statistics that fall in the critical area even when there is no treatment effect. So this is a gauge of your chance of being wrong claiming an effect is this percent here. And the probability of a type 1 error is the percent of statistics that naturally fall here with no effect. The names for this are this percent that we use to figure out our critical F, p-value, p because it's the probability of making a type 1 error. It's also known as alpha. Some people will call it a significance level. P is the same as alpha, is the same as what people call a significance level. All it is the probability that you're making this kind of error, type 1 error, a false positive. This one here. And this p-value is this percent. It's the percent of statistics that would happen in this region anyway, regardless, even if there's no effect. So you need to know automatically what p and alpha stands for. It's the percent chance that you're going to make a type 1 error or a false positive. You also need to know it's sort of like a level of doubt when you're claiming an effect. If I have a 5% chance of being wrong when I claim an effect, it might be safe to say, well, I think there's an effect, and there's a 5% chance that I'm wrong. I have a 5% level of doubt. So think of your p-value as your level of doubt. Do not think of your p-value or alpha as the size of the effect. Whether the effect is big or small is a completely different question. All that P or alpha tells you is my chance of being wrong or my level of doubt when I claim an effect.